to Star Wars The Old Republic. So, we are going to be continuing the Bounty Hunter storyline. We are here on Terrace. We are supposed to be grabbing rat ghoul fluids, a carcass, and rat ghoul excrement. Because Torian Kadera apparently needs it. Game, please bring up the map. I need to be able to see. Thank you very much. Ha! Ah. Alright, let's test that again. Cool. Alright, game's just catching up. Game's just catching up. We're good, we're good. Rotting rat ghoul carcass. Boom. Trouble on the way. Three more. Owned. Owned. I mean, it's not exactly the Chris Kyle subclass, but... Every single class storyline has you do something involving this area with rat ghouls. I was thinking about doing, if this game does end up going kaput and we're no longer able to play it, I was thinking about doing a Skyrim playthrough or an Oblivion playthrough. And I know I don't have anybody in the audience right now, but for those of you at home watching later on the channel, would you like to see an Oblivion playthrough or a Skyrim playthrough? Oblivion is the, those of you that don't know, is the older version. Not the older version, but the older game. The fuck? Using the red, using red gray unironically? Cringe. Like fucking cringe. I doubt it still functions, but it looks like it held up to the destruction pretty well. Can we get through it? Yeah, we can. There are rat ghoul events that do occur in this game. Like rat ghouls can infect you. See, with the thing about the sniper compared to the regular old operative is that the sniper is meant for range. You're not supposed to get up close and personal. But the operative actually gets to use their combat knife a little bit more compared to the sniper, which doesn't allow you to use it at all.
Hey, smelled you coming.
Here are the materials.
The cool byproducts you asked for.
Let me. This'll take a minute. Stuff will throw a rat ghoul off my trail, but in their den, keep your blaster ready.
So what's this gunk supposed to do exactly?
Mask our scent, tranquilize, smear it thick. If the fumes put the rat ghouls out, we might sneak through.
Well, that's a smell. If I pass out, please don't leave me behind.
So now we have Torian Kadera as a secondary companion.
Your distance.
This is where picking the operative would have come in handy. Holy shit.
Hear that? Nothing?
I've got a bad feeling about this.
Trap!
I really don't like the sound of that.
Kill rat ghouls in the vault, huh?
Oh.
Oh. Go.
Why does everything always want to eat us?
So, this artist finally sending children to do his dirty work? Run home now and tell Mandalore if he wants my head, he should come and take it himself.
You gonna face me like a warrior, or make me chase you all over Terrace?
Think real hard, girl, before you go issuing challenges you might regret. I will tell you what I told the others. You've survived. You have earned the right to the Garoya Beharan. If you lose, however, I will kill you. I'll be waiting at these coordinates. Then we'll see who hunts whom.
Is he expecting us?
Personally, no. He's toying with us. But the Garoya Beharan gives us an opening. It's a Mandalorian death game. There are four parts. Ali Jate, personal honors. Yeme Sum, the homeworld. The Sterebise, who defends a legacy. And the Nost, who destroys it. He will place honors, prized possessions around a battlefield. You will try to take them. If you take all of them, then you must take his home.
I just wander the swamp looking for clues?
I'll scout for Jikon's honors while you go to face him. And while you run the game, I'll find his home. Call me when you've made your challenge.
All right. I think there's a fast travel point that we can use. So let's go to the garrison. Let's get our shit repaired. Sell junk. Repair all.
Be well.
So the thing about playing through the Bounty Hunter storyline is that you don't have to be a Mandalorian. When Mandalore the Vindicated gives you the opportunity to join, you can just say, no, the Mandalorians can fuck off. My character, however, chose to join them, and that's why we're wearing the armor. Apparently we have mail. Free at last. Alright. I've come to terms with the tragedy of the Aurora. The masters at the temple helped me clear my mind and of the hate I held for you, but I see things clearly now. I don't believe you're evil, but you are misguided, and the path you walk can only bring you to a dark place. You can be saved. There's still time to choose a different life for yourself. Please answer for what you've done. You can't run forever, and you're only hurting yourself by trying. If you accept responsibility for the harm you've caused, you can earn a second chance in time. Yeah, fuck all of that. So that was from the Padawan of the Jedi Master we killed as part of the Great Hunt. There are ways around fighting. There are always alternatives to fighting. Cathar. Ah, fuck me.
I'm at the coordinates. No sign of Jikholm. Just some sort of marker.
Not good.
Hey, are you alright?
You okay? What happened?
Challenge accepted.
That's how you want to play, Jikholm.
Transmission cut out. Transmitting coordinates. Should be all of the traitor's honors. Contact you when I found his bolt hole. Torian out.
Very motherfucking well. So now we gotta go traipsing around the swamp finding all of this shit. But tradition must be upheld.
Bad. It's usually over by now. Let's see how far you get.
We're only wearing Durasteel, so it makes sense that he could hit us. So we're gonna go like that. Hey, look, Beskad. That would not be a practical sword to wield. Like, we don't even have an actual Beskar sword. We have Beskads in this game. We have a Beskar spear as well, but Beskads and that spear are both meant to be ceremonial. Medal of Conquest.
You're a real spitfire. If I were young again, I might take you as a bride, girl.
Found the traitor's bolt hole. Wreckage. Crashed ship. The Indar Spire.
Good work, Torian. I'll let you know when I've got Jikholm on the run.
Keep the pressure on. I'll start laying a trap. I'll call when everything's in position.
Nah, bruv. You fucked. But yeah, the reason I ask why you guys would want to see, like, what you guys would want to see between Skyrim and Oblivion. Skyrim has more customization in terms of, like, just character customization and making and mods. Oblivion is, like, to put it in perspective, my mod list for Oblivion is like 25 mods tops, maybe 30. But I have 233 mods in my Skyrim load order. Prize trophy, huh?
Finding one that quickly could have been dumb luck. Two, you're getting help. Let's slow you down.
Torian, that trap ready?
No, and the traitor's on his way back.
Jigolin's still got one cachet left. You think he's on to us?
He's just changing strategy. You're winning. He's coming to fortify his stronghold. Transmitting location. I'll do what I can. Hurry.
But the storylines in Oblivion, in my opinion at least, are much, much better. That could just be because Oblivion was my introduction to the series. And, you know, it's more of a preference based on that the fact that I played it first. The Dark Brotherhood storyline is much more interesting. It's not just go and do some errands, some minor contracts, and go and do some minor contracts, go sit in the Night Mother's coffin and you become the listener. Nah, like there's actual effort that's involved with the Dark Brotherhood and Oblivion. But, you actually have to try and start. Well, actually, no, you don't have to try. But with the Dark Brotherhood in Oblivion, you can join by accident. All you have to do is kill somebody, and it will a message will appear in the top screen that says, "You have been observed by forces unseen." And the next time you sleep, which a lot of players don't really sleep all that often in Oblivion unless they're trying to roleplay, but when they next time you sleep, you will meet Lucian Lechance, and he will give you the Blade of Woe, which is at that point in time, of Elder Scrolls history, a staple item of the Dark Brotherhood. And he'll tell you to go kill this dude named Rufio. None of my kit works in here. There we go. Bink. Here we go. Grenade. Go, I swear to fucking God. Disable scanners. Oh, hi, Torian.
Torian, where's Jakon?
Got cocky. He's tricky. Electronet put him down, but used it to cook off his munition cache. He's running. Don't let the trail go cold.
Does Jakon have another hideaway?
Didn't see one. Doesn't matter. You can catch him. He's hurt. Bleeding. Running. Deep tracks. Bloody mud. Straight lines. Even you could follow.
We're finishing this together, Torian. It's not up for discussion.
So close.
Let's get these scanners disabled and get ourselves a med kit.
All right, kid. The Koltos treated most of the major damage.
Should have left me. You've given the traitor too much time.
I went with my gut, and it was the right thing to do.
At least I get another crack at him. The traitor sacrificed his stockpile to escape. He'll be scavenging now. Most likely, he'll steal from nearby outposts.
I'll give you that one.
We should update our tactical maps at an Imperial outpost, then search for signs of the traitor at any outpost nearby.
Creator command base, huh? That's here, so... But yeah, so the, back to talking about Oblivion. The storylines in Oblivion are better. You don't have a bullshit werewolf club that forces you to be a werewolf to advance the storyline and then give you the option to cure it. But, like, you have the Fighter's Guild. Like, you actually have the Fighter's Guild.
At your service, sir. Brother Root is confirmed.
You don't have the College of Winterhold. You have the Mages Guild and the Arcane University. That storyline is much better, in my opinion, than the College of Winterhold. Because the College of Winterhold is just show up, go on an excavation, go to an archaeological dig site, fight some Draugr, find this uber powerful magic item that you can't use, but will get used against you, and then go and find this other magical artifact that you do get to use, but it's really underpowered and doesn't hold up to end game content. Like, even the guide for Skyrim that Bethesda themselves put out admitted that the Staff of Magnus was not an actual weapon meant to be used for endgame content. Like, it doesn't hold up. It doesn't do enough damage. It doesn't do anything useful to the player except for kill anomalies really fast. Where do I have to go for this? Okay, there
sure
we go.
Going the right way? I don't see anything.
Looks right.
But with the Mage's Guild, it forces you to do something tedious. It makes you travel around to every Mage's Guild location in every city. It still gives you a connection to the Mage's Guild. Like, you actually feel like helping them is doing something. Because with getting into the College of Winterhold, it's just pass a test.
I think I found a track. Never mind, it's yours.
Trail's still strong.
But, you go to every single Mage's Guild location, you do a quest for someone there, and they write a recommendation for you to be let into the Arcane University. The whole time you're ranking up, and it's always like, it's not always something like go clear out a dungeon. Sometimes it can be things like I can only really think of one time they actually make the player clear out a dungeon. Actually, it's two. Because one is for a seer stone.
Does this look like blood to you?
And then the other is for bringing somebody, like bringing a daedrologist back to the guild hall. But the whole time you're fighting the Order of the Black Worm. Like, that is the main antagonist of the Mage's Guild storyline.
This is hard. I don't know how you guys do it.
For the Fighters Guild, you go around and you do, like, you do just run around and do mercenary work. But eventually you have to join the Blackwater Company in order to help out the Fighters Guild, because they want to know why exactly the Blackwater Company gets paid to do all these jobs, but why they never really have repeat business. Like, how exactly are they being seen as the end-all be-all of efficient mercenaries, but they have like high casualty rates of civilians and shit. Group Green and yellow. Nice.
You gave a good run.
Duty and vengeance.
Might have done me in if you hadn't left the finale to a novice. You and Artis have something in common. You're content to let the young do your dying for you.
There's nowhere left to run, Jakon.
This is as good a place as any for my last stand. Let's finish burying the past. This game's gone on long enough.
Just to start really fucking him up. Where's my interrogation probe?
Just do it.
He and I aren't done. Lise Gar Su Johar Ir. Har Joha Darmanda. Ibi Turgar. Darbu Ir Balish.
Mevain? Ner? Nerad? Oyash? I have a last request, Hunter. I want a moment to speak with my...
Don't ask me to translate that.
I can spare a few minutes.
I speak a little bit of Mandoa, but not a lot.
Carrying your name like a mark of shame. I fought a righteous battle. You'll never get me to admit otherwise.
I understand.
Take my head to Mandalore if you're gonna. I'm tired.
This is your call to make, kid.
I'm sorry.
Gar Taldin. Nija On. Gar Sabui. O Riwa Dasla.
I'll do our name proud. That wasn't what I expected.
You seem shook up. What did he say to you?
Nothing I didn't already know. Just differently told. I want to be alone. It's been an honor.
Here, let me. I'm at least gonna say one word in Mandoa regarding Taurian. Par Gila Verda. Triumphant warrior. So that was Taurian's dad. Taurian's father, for those of you just joining us, rallied an army against Mandalore the Vindicated and went against the sixth tenant of the Rezolnir, which is Answer the Call of Mandalore. Let's switch back to the Merc now that we don't need to be honoring a parent and justice.
I am truly honored to serve such a person as you, Master. History will remember your name. Not mine, but definitely yours.
The ante isn't that bad.
You've been out there a while.
Really didn't want to come back empty-handed, did you?
Calling it quits? No shame in bowing out after a good run?
You don't call it quitting after you cross the finish line. I've got your body bloodworthy. Bioscan incoming.
These scans match the data I have on file.
You actually caught him? How do you like that?
It would have been a shame if old age turned out to be the only match for Chink and Kadera. Transferring your jackpot now. Impressive work. Records indicate you are the 28th hunter to place a stake on that bounty, 12th to return.
Don't look so proud of yourself. You bagged somebody's grandpa. Your lucky streak won't last.
Keep telling yourself that.
Don't have to.
All right, Shula. We've all got better things to do than talk trash. I'll make arrangements for the Mandalorians to take Jinkin off your hands. Expect a shuttle shortly. We'll be in touch.
So, for those of you that don't know, Jikon Kadera was part of the Blacklist bounties. Only the champions of the Great Hunt can actually view those bounties, and they the members of the Great Hunt would put into a pot. Each member would put money into this pot, and they would be sent to Terrace to go find Jikon Kadera. But not all of them would return. As the Defenestrator said, that's the droid, we are the 12th to return of 28 to be sent after him. But Bloodworthy, way back in the last stream, said that every new member adds to the pot. It's been added to so many times over the years that it's an exorbitant amount of money. We have 16 million credits, guys. See, down here, we have 16 million credits.
Orshaw, wasting no time earning new honors, I see. We've been sent to collect the traitor from you.
He's in the cargo bay.
Burshaw.
Need to ask you a favor, champion. I want to come with you.
Didn't get enough of me yet?
Guess not. I mean to serve, join your hunts, earn respect for my clan.
How could you say no to a face like that?
Give me this honor.
I'm flattered, kid. Welcome aboard.
Thank you.
We're done. Coming, Torian?
Nope.
You can finally show your face, and now you're running off. Try to make something of yourself, Arutal.
Arutal means traitor.
When you are.
Well, so it's not Arutal itself doesn't mean traitor. Let's see. Aruti is traitor, or Arutish is traitor, but Arutal most likely means traitor's kid or traitor's son.
Torian. He'll be joining us, so get properly introduced.
Always room for one more in my book. I'm Mako.
Galt Renault, at your service.
Pleasure.
Not much to look at, but it's home.
No complaints.
Get Torian settled. We're heading out.
Come on, I'll give you the tour. Nice! Now I know we hit the big time!
What makes you say that?
Offers have been piling up since we won the Great Hunt. Mostly not worth our time, but I think we finally struck the motherlode. Some bigwig from Adas Corp just sent us an offer with more zeros than I can count.
Been thinking I don't get enough work in the private sector these days.
Get this. It isn't even for a bounty. they want you to endorse their new line of battlefield adrenals. They're willing to give their current spokesperson the boot, but only if you pick up the contract as soon as possible.
I'm a professional hunter, not some celebrity mouthpiece.
Well, I am, and for that much money, I'd be glad to fill in for you.
Some dignity.
Can't hurt to hear them out. We're supposed to visit a Daskorp's plant on Quest to talk terms.
Let me handle the negotiations and we'll be rolling in credits. I'll only take a 30% cut.
Not how I'd want to be remembered.
So, we headed to Quest?
Tell the Daskorp I'll take their offer under consideration.
Okay, but don't make me nag you. This is way too good an opportunity to miss because you forgot about it. The Holonet says the Empire and Republic are disputing whose territory Quest is. Better be careful if we head there.
If you hear me fiddling around with a furry animal, my cat is in my lap right now, and he's being a bellend.
Way easier to slice than I thought. Which is sort of worrying now that I think about it. Did some poking around in a few classified Republic databases. Found my
24,220 credits.
Maybe. Found a dozen birth certificates, all with the gene stamp, a lot like mine.
A dozen is a lot of targets. Doesn't tell us where to start looking.
Well, no, it doesn't, but it's still a great find. My family's records. It's gotta be. Parents, siblings, maybe grandparents, who knows what else. No names or dates, though, just an SIS project number.
See, as we go down...
I have to keep looking, see what else I can find.
So basically, she found a shit ton of people that have the same gene stamp as hers, in their birth certificate. Torian, baby boy, come here.
Thanks for the help, you twink. Decent of you to let me in on the kill. You didn't have to do that.
Let's see. Found a dozen birth certificates, all with a gene stamp a lot like mine.
Couldn't let him keep dragging your clan's honor through the dirt.
Vor Intge.
Thank you.
Looking forward to this. Not everyone gets to fight beside the champion of the Great Hunt.
Actually, hold up. Yeah, for NTA is thank you.
I can think of better things for us to do than fight.
Something to consider. Say the word. I'm ready to move out.
Let me tell you a little thing about opportunity.
What makes you think I need advice on the subject?
You're more an in-the-moment type. Sometimes you've got to see the potential farther down the road. Take this group of fresh-off-the-shuttle Arcona I met at the Mos Eila spaceport before you showed up. I left those Arcona with a stellar impression of Geller Rowing, helpful merchant, and earmarked them for a return trip once things died down.
So you're planning to sell them junk speeders?
That's small time, friend. I don't think you fully appreciate the caliber of moron we're dealing with. Seems fresh water's hard to come by on Kona. These rubes heard about moisture farming on Tatooine and figured it was their ticket to riches. Fleecing these yokels will be like taking candy from a baby. The key is finding the right scheme.
What are we aiming for?
We need something with a low overhead, something we can keep going for a while. Moisture farmers aren't exactly rolling in credits, but a whole colony of them can add up. Have I mentioned how much pulling that little con has improved my mood? I think that auction put to bed any lingering doubts that Tiresias is dead and gone. And aside from knowing my new identity ought to stick, I'd almost forgotten how much I love a good scheme.
Does this mean you're going to stop pacing the ship at all hours?
Sure, unless I'm planning our next big score. It's hard to work a proper hustle when you're on the run, chum. I've pulled more heists than cons in recent memory. That was the kind of racket my former partner preferred. Simple, bold, effective. Used to argue about that a lot.
You had other preferences.
Armed robbery is one of the few things I enjoy in moderation. My preference is to be long gone by the time anyone gets wise. That's a lot easier without bounty hunters breathing down my neck. It's about time I got back in the game. Can't afford to let myself get out of practice, after all.
All right, so that's all that. Let's see, what exactly is that? That is caused by the Hunter Gauntlets. Son of a bitch. All right, looks like we gotta go back into the... Gonna go back into this and get the... Get some gauntlets out of here. Are you the Reforged? Here, we'll just keep this on hand. There we go. If you're wondering what that noise is, look carefully. See, you see that? That little hook thing right there? If I press Z and I put the guns away, it folds back into the gauntlet. So, the most obvious change that you'll see when my character is in combat is the visor, that rangefinder. Here, let's... Bink! Look at that. See, the rangefinder went from being up to being down. That's actually what that is. It is a rangefinder. Boba Fett uses it in Empire Strikes Back. Like, he has it down over the visor. Alright, and we're going to switch from using Mako to using Torian Kadera. It is the Mandalorian ideal that a warrior be judged by his or her own actions, not by those of his or her ancestors. But reality rarely lives up to the ideals. Torian Kadera has spent his entire short life trying to overcome the stigma of being a traitor's son, a shame he has seldom been allowed to forget in the company of his peers. But Torian long ago learned to armor himself against contempt, and others' doubts regarding his loyalty have only driven him to strive harder to prove his worth. Because of this, Torian adheres to the codes and traditions of the Mandalorians with more devotion than many twice his age. Upholding honor and enduring adversity are the cornerstones of his existence. He likes challenges, honor, Mandalorians, and respect. He dislikes selling out and cowardice. I think we might have to start everything, the story arc request before we can go. Yep, inoculated by the medical officer.
Here for inoculation. You'll need form 1423/D and, excuse me.
It says /D, but there's -D.
Time, but few have your reputation. Let's forget the red tape. I take it you're here to fight in the Quesh War?
Just point me towards the battle.
This planet generally doesn't inspire excitement. Quesh is highly toxic, poisoned by the resource the Republic's mining. You'll need a protective injection just to survive. There we go. That treatment will protect you for the time being.
The protection wears off?
The effects will fade eventually, but you can receive more treatments planetside. You're cleared. Talk to Moff Drayson if you want to fight. He's in charge of the Empire's war effort.
Oh. Alright.
Stinks worse than rat ghouls. Gonna be nose deaf for a week.
Gotta wait for the elevator to come up.
I'll keep it close.
Give companion gifts. Let's not run everywhere. That would be a good idea. Wow, we really could have just fast traveled up here. Holy shit. Don't be like me, kids. Don't be a dumbass. Fuck me. There we go.
So you're my hunter? Yes, I see it now. The pictures don't do you justice. Excuse my manners. Peyton Swole, Director of Galactic Relations.
Let's get down to business, Director.
We can discuss the terms of contractual partnership in my office. This way, please. Make yourself comfortable. May I offer you anything?
How can I be of service to a DAS Corp?
Valerie, send in a refreshment cart. Spare no expense.
Knew I didn't like this.
Agent Dahl, Strategic Information Service. I'm placing you under arrest for the murder of Jedi Master Kellyan Jarro and the destruction of the Republic cruiser Aurora.
If you've got a problem, take it up with my employer.
We plan to, after you clarify a few things. Cooperate, and you might not spend the rest of your life behind bars.
We can take him.
Knight.
You spared my life. The courts will take that into consideration if you come peacefully.
Vendus, relieve the bounty hunter of weaponry. Cautiously. They're a tricky bunch.
I know that too well, Master.
I'm gonna pretend this never happened. I suggest you do the same.
Don't let her escape.
Very well.
Gotcha.
Ah! Bink.
You've only made matters worse for yourself.
You forced this outcome.
I doubt a jury would agree.
Teaching to mess with Mandos. Kelly and Jaro, you took down the Mandalorian killer.
He was my final target in the Great Hunt.
Good target. More trouble.
I thought the body count was low anyway.
Use your ship's intercom. Yeah, nah, we're not doing jack fucking shit like that. We're not doing jack fucking shit about defeating SIS reinforcements. We're just dipping. Come on.
Easy Street now, or what?
Twas a trap.
Was a Republic setup.
What? How? That offer letter was 100% legitimate. I traced it back to a DasCorp and cross-checked all the digital signatures.
It wasn't a forgery. They were cooperating with the SIS.
The Strategic Information Service. We have to be seriously careful to stay off their scanners. Looks like Bloodworthy's on the line. I'll patch him too.
And before you ask, yes, all of that is required.
Just wanted to transfer your next target. That is, if you're ready for another blacklist favorite.
Double or nothing?
No wagers this time. Not between us, anyway. This bounty's years shy of beating Jacone's time. But anything sitting on the blacklist more than a month is real trouble. I'm putting my money on you this time. So try not to get yourself killed.
What's our next move?
We've got another blacklist mark to deal with. Have the next blacklist bounty's coordinates logged by the time I'm ready to head out.
Will do.
My cat keeps picking up his bowl and dropping it. Alright, let's... Boom, cold weather gear, fuck yeah.
Mako, open a secure channel on the frequency we got from the blacklist.
Come on. Signal strength is really poor. Oh, there we go. Sorta.
This is unexpected. I greet you on behalf of the Chiss Ascendancy, Bounty Hunter. I am Aristocra Shorehard-Lilithia. This hollow frequency hasn't had an inquiry in quite some time. I believe there were no longer any interested parties.
If you've got a job, I've got interest.
I need someone to hunt the Trandoshan pirate lord, Renegade Voss. Are you such an individual?
May as well ask us to hunt the ghost of Nagus Sato.
You lost me.
Renegade Voss is almost spacer superstition. Something to tell the kids.
Just because Voss lurks in what your people pointedly refer to as the unknown regions, doesn't mean he does not exist. He is quite real and presently wreaking havoc on Chiss-occupied territory.
What else can you tell me about Voss?
Very little, unfortunately. He's never left anyone alive to give a proper report. Voss appears to have joined up with the White Moor, a massive confederacy of pirates pillaging Hoth's starship graveyard. Their raids have operations to smoking wreckage.
Boss, your only target of interest here?
He's the only target you need to concern yourself with. We've permitted the Empire to use Hoth for strategic purposes in exchange for their assistance dislodging the pirates. Imperial soldiers will handle the White Moor, however, boss. Bye.
Imperial grunts can't be trusted with this kind of work.
Our patrols recently captured one of the White Moor pirates out in the wastes. It may be able to point you to Voss once you arrive. I'm transmitting credentials that will allow you unrestricted access to Hoth's surface. Use them to travel to these coordinates. Contact me when you've secured Voss.
Hell fucking yeah. Hold up. Damn, all y'all are up here. Holy shit.
What sort of jobs are coming up? Hunting? Mercenary work?
You never know in this business.
Should keep me on my toes. Been in a few skirmishes. Treaty with the Republic made real fighting scarce. Like to see something worthy.
You really want to see something worthy? I could oblige.
Knew coming with you was a good idea. Our people need battle to find out what we are. Mando without war is like a starship without space.
Guess we better find you a war then.
Looking forward to it.
Come on.
Been watching you work. You're an amazing shot.
We could get the ship to ourselves. I'll show you all kinds of things I'm good with.
We should find some downtime first. It's nice to see a professional in action. Quite the view.
I'd be happy to give you a better view anytime.
I'll remember you said that.
Don't ask why I'm flirting with Torian, okay? Just don't ask.
Remember the SIS project number I found? 32? Turns out if you search for it in enough super secret Republic databases, it gets noticed. Ran into a little, trouble. Like, if I keep doing this, the chance of mysteriously disappearing goes up dramatically, sort of trouble.
Doesn't sound so bad. You let that scare you off?
Thought I'd ask you to test it. Maybe the billion or so agents I'll send just hand out free candy. Figure there are other, less hazardous channels I can look into. I'll, let you know if I decide to do anything stupid. Or, more likely, let you know after.
Mako.
Remember how I said I'd avoid SIS databases for the time being? Decided this was a good time to take a crack at the encryption on that SIS creep Carteri's datapad. The encryption is crazy. Someone threw a solid wall of credits into keeping this thing secure.
Anyone goes to that much trouble to keep a secret, it's gotta be something serious.
That's the scary part. I mean, I'm seriously getting the creeps now. What's my family involved in that's worth this kind of money to the Republic?
You're really upset about this.
I don't know if it's about my family or Brayden or just a puzzle I can't solve. It's making me crazy. Anyway, thanks for listening to me babble. Much appreciated.
Remember those Arcona colonists I was telling you about? Well, I've got the perfect racket to skim a little profit off those moisture-farming saps. Salt.
As in table salt?
Well, I'm not talking bath salts, considering water is a luxury good. Listen, I've got a theory. I used to know this spacey Arconan bagman back on Nar Shaddaa. Thought the guy was a spice head for the longest time. Turns out I was only half right. This guy's cravings were something else.
Your friend had some sort of reaction.
Can't say for certain, but I've got my suspicions. One night, after making our handoff in some dive diner, he orders some garbage soup and dumps an entire shaker of salt into the bowl. Should have seen the way this guy went at the stuff before stumbling out of the place like its last call.
So you want to sell them salt?
Do we look like two credit traders? We're going to sell those colonists the answer to all their woes, specially formulated and offered exclusively through Rowing Industries. If I'm right about how much Arcona loved the stuff, our biggest problem will be keeping up the supply.
Okay. Come on, game. Come on, game. Load, please. Don't crash. Not right now. Not in front of the people. You can crash all you want when we're just playing by myself, but Christ on ice skates, man. No! No. No. Oh, God. Oh, fuck me. All right. So it looks like I got to go ahead and end the stream. Never mind. Never mind. Do I? Ah, damn it. It's having trouble loading. All right. Well, it hasn't crashed yet. All right. All right, come on, game. It's not that hard to load. There we go, baby. Oh, fuck me. All right. That happens sometimes. It's loading an entirely new area of the game. Here we go. Here we go. Oh, fuck.
I'm here to interrogate your prisoner.
This can't be authentic. Wait here. I mean it. You will please excuse my manners before. The prisoner is right this way. Little rat has been nothing but trouble.
What do you mean?
It slipped out of its cell 6 times since the patrols brought it in. Don't ask me how. Never makes a run for it, though. Just noses around and starts taking things apart. It's driving me crazy.
Ooh, space armor. Good color. You paint mini lights and flybox soon, yes? It have flame maker, too.
Think all the white mall will be this threatening?
Good luck understanding it. Show yourself out when you're finished.
By the way, Houtini just means wow. This nice blaster. You have big hands. How you hold this?
hand it over, or you'll become well acquainted with my...
God damn it.
Give it back, and I'll show you. Aren't you a little far from home?
Uh-huh. Home small and boring. All old sand, older junk. Blizz joined band to work on Space Crawler for Friend Slam. Blizz never see friends again now. Stupid, dreely tomb. Well, tell Foreman Blizz steal tech and hide things under cot. Boss vows drag Blizz along on hunt in cold white sand. Sick crew on Blizz like pack of womp rats. Can't go back now.
Where's the last place you saw them?
Blizz been here a little while now. Make good guess though. Try hunting camp, boss vows drag Blitz too. Down in big ice cave, it not far. Maybe he's still there. Boss vows always fighting and killing. Scary, scary. You do not have to chase him. Be careful. Jawas.
Join up to let the weather do me in.
Please use all products only as intended. Be well.
All right. We kind of gotta stick around on the road, otherwise we fall into a ravine. Not a good idea. We're getting there. So, real quick, the road we got to get to is right there at the tip of the cursor. Come on. navigate around the talls here. Come on, you fucks. Fucking wampas, man. We're getting there. Come on. Ah, shit. Now offer beast to scorekeeper. Show you are worthy hunter to of her notice. Grah, not like that. There, that is how you give praise to Scorekeeper, with blood on your teeth. I hear you, who lurks in darkness while we feast. Carrion eaters are unwelcome here. Do not intrude on this hunt.
It's not your hunt you should be worried about, Snakeskin.
This bounty hunter comes from my blood. She shall leave disappointed. I have torn eyes from Wookiee chieftains with bare claws alone, feasted on crate dragon flesh, crushed armadas. I do not debase my Jagannath by swatting yapping dogs.
You wouldn't be the first unstoppable target I've taken down.
You need more than tough talk to impress Scorekeeper. You are nothing to me, soft thing hiding in hard shell. Unknown, untested, unworthy, bigger prey awaits me. This manhunter has spirit. Boost your young blood scores nicely. I leave her to you. Paint your glories in her blood. Come on. Help, boss, help, come back. She's too tough.
I heard boss was a holy terror. Why'd he leave you to do the dirty work?
Captain think we weak, make him look bad. Take us on hunt to show us how we be strong. We hunt small prey, he hunt big. You come and captain say you small, so we fight, but you not small. I just want to go back to mop decks. Useless.
Bye, piggy.
Boss didn't think much of us.
Come on, we're paying Blizz another visit.
All right, I'm going to try to toy around with a new concept I'm working with. I want to see if having shorter streams, at least even by 30 minutes, if that actually helps viewership on YouTube, or at least viewer retention. So I will see you guys next time. May the force be with you, and have a good night.